chilly morning with the sun shining, peeking over the horizon, no hurry to get the day going. There's something about morning, perhaps the rain and a fresh scent in the air. What is a beautiful day? 75 degrees all day, soft and fluffy cumulus clouds touching the sky. Perhaps the sun produces an icy fire rainbow on them. A breeze to push them away and bring more. That is a cool touch to the skin. What is a beautiful day? A warm evening, jet streams and broken clouds painted pink from the setting sun late in the day. Stars poking the sky. What is a beautiful night? A blanket of perfect temperature. Stars stretch all over, shaping into people and animals, and the moon shines down on earth and plants glow. Mostly everything is silent except for the owls calling.
I'm Mel McKernan. I'll be reading Different Lenses on page 107. You were born with rose-colored glasses. I lived life in grayscale. The world through your eyes is beautiful, vibrant, and warm. You try to convince me of your truth, but all I can see is dull, muted, and blurred. This is my own truth. I wonder what it's like in your world, what life is like without the clouds. Is the sky really as blue as they say it is? Do you take it for granted, the flowers, the fresh air, the bird song? Does the sunshine burn your skin like it does mine, or is it kinder to you? Maybe it spares those who actually deserve its light. You were born with rose-colored glasses. I live life in grayscale. We view the world through different lenses. Although we walk alongside each other, our realities are contrasting. We both hold on to our own truth of the world, the people in it, and their intentions. I don't need you to see the world the way I do. I don't want you to, but I need you to understand and stop rushing me to change. Because believe me, if I could, I would.
Hi, my name is Cameron Carter, and I will be reading Unannounced Visitor on page 24. It arrived unannounced 9 years ago, when the day was supposed to be joyous and fun. Christmas Day's red and green was tainted black as the ink-stained thoughts invaded my mind and surrounded my soul with tar. My equal, who I was supposed to love, was a match that was never supposed to burn. The match that quickly flew from a burning stick to a burning field of raging confusion. The presence under the tree held no meaning anymore. Instead, a reminder that my being would never be pure. My thoughts would never return to their peaceful ways. The voices would never fade away the way they did fading in. The scars on my skin will remain like the marks of a sword slashed into a tree. The blood that escapes my blood. My body would be replaced just like I was. The Christmas tree standing colorful and bright, it too will eventually wither from the harshness of life. The star atop it, merely a reminder that you can always grasp the fake, but never the reality that is a million miles away. The oversized socks stuffed full of useless junk, presenting the feeling of uselessness and bringing to the forefront the evil ethos. The outside may be pretty, but the inside is what everyone looks at. The magical train playing across the TV, the nausea you can never be there is what lights the realization that none of it is real. The very thought that clouds the water and melts the jar of dreams between its flames along with a small notes of future. This beautiful beast with eyes that are definition of blood and body dripping with the guts of darkness. It moves with such grace and silence, you think of it as a dark being trying to find the light. Except it lights the pitch black. It lurks in any alley inside the ever dawn. The happiness in a bottle only goes it for so long, so why is the light worth it? It haunts everyone at some point, but why have I been a victim for so long?
I'm Dylan Cohn, and I'll be reading From on page 42. Fried rice for dinner, microwave lunch will be pizza for lunch. I come from a place where my father forgets me at school. Somewhere I have cereal for dinner and a brownie for dessert. A place that I can wake up in the morning and hear the birds chirp. somewhere it never snows, unless I'm sleeping. I come from Stephen King as a bedtime story. I come from, get up, you are in the dog bed again. A place where going to Goodwill is a treat. Somewhere someone says, what do you want from Taco Bell? Again? I come from Red Hot Chili Peppers and obscure Star Wars references. Somewhere we only swim at 2 because that's when the sun hits the pool just right. I come from a family made of 3, then 5, then 7, then 8, then 4.
Isabella Edwards, just like the movie Twilight. And on page 56, you'll find Billboard and Skygazer on 56. Record-like personas are not for me. I prefer to identify as a DVD. My movie plays on a big screen, on a billboard for the world to see. Half-assed acting and auto-tune should not be considered entertainment. Record-like personas, I assume, attract those who can't handle talent. Forget pretty faces and half-naked girls and stars who dress for attention, or controversial bold headlines and clip-on curls and singers who are paid to lip-sync. My singular bland movie on the billboard up above, I'd rather keep viewing than artificial snobs. Skygazer is, I was dressed in a completely inappropriate shade of pink. Pink is for the girls who strive to be adored, who tag along with what they're told is best, and who have no desire to step out of their destructive pink pattern. He has always known I'm attracted to blue, and turned green at the set of pink. What's wrong? You don't like it? Most importantly, you don't like it. Spun his legs around and played animal on the floor, like a mouse, he approached the dresser with a cheek-to-cheek grin, and he picked up an elegant, solid blue dress and tossed it through the air. The shade of blue made me long for cloud watching. He guided me by my chin to the sky, I found the love so dearly. On went the blue shaded suit of confidence, and we danced all night. In each room did we rave and took pretend to be ballet dancers and pop and lock. We tumbled onto a cloud, gazed into the sky, and just drifted off to sleep.
Reading You Will Forget Me on page 60. You won't remember my name. You didn't know it before, and you will forget it after. You will turn back time to the pages of the beginning so you can catch a glimpse of what I am before I'm gone. You will swim to the depths of the seas to search for the ancient record of words to try and find my own. You will, because right now, you do remember. You remember because this is the top of the page, the first heartbeat of a draft, the slowest sparking of a novel. Your synapses will brand themselves with my identity, then all too quickly burn out from disuse. You will forge your mind with ink so hot they shine like ivory suns. Bolster and stoke this flame inside, you'll spend your days to prove me wrong. I don't care if I've forgotten. The meaning of the message is the purpose, not the poet. You didn't know my name before, you won't know it after. I'm a pedestrian, passerby, bystander, spectator, who wants nothing less than to change your life forever, even if you forget my name. This is The Smell of Coffee at 7 p.m. in the summer on page 74. Bright orange rays drip from the sun, paint your freckles and drift onto your half-up, half-down perfect smile. It seeps into the memory of us. Color theory was embedded in the creation of you and I. We were warm colors, against a cool sky. We were never blue. And together or alone, that will never change. The smell of coffee at 7 p.m. in the summer will be our remembrance always. There are sparks of rebirth in our sentimental eyes, tangled between flecks of honey and gold. We scatter the past into the future. Red flowers lay on the door and yellow 35mm film rays that raises the walls. It doesn't matter if we end up together or alone, when a deep cold winter crashes against the windows, we'll be ready. The past leads us into the future. We'll be who we are and we want to become.
My name is Casey Ingram and I will read Anger on page 84. Anger is loud and obnoxious. He makes you feel worked up. Wanting to do something you'll regret later in the future. Often alone and isolated, he doesn't have very good social skills. Brings out opinions that don't matter to people, getting angry at the people he loves. His taste in music is horrible, heavy metal. He calls it true music, I call it trash. He is like a building blowing up in flames, spreading over everything he can touch, bringing them into the fire to burn in his anger. He's says he wants to change, but always finds new ways to make his problem worse. He cannot relax, cannot sleep those nights. He always has something bothering him, always something to complain about. It's not that great to be angry all the time. Think about it.
Hi, I'm Catherine Alestra. Most of you guys know me as Katie. I was a mentor in this class, and I'm going to be sharing two poems with you, one from the book and one that was unpublished. First, How to Work on page 84. If these walls could talk, I'd hear an endless conversation. Their voices would crowd and surround me like a never-ending sea. They would tell me to get up, go to sleep. But mostly, they'd ask me if I was okay on those special days. They would stare at me at 3 a.m. when the time where all I'm doing is zoning out and refusing sleep because of the impossible dreams. If these walls could talk, they would ask me things. How's the world? Has anything changed? Are you okay? Is it one of those days? Sometimes these walls were my only friends. One wears a rainbow flag and holds makeup. Another displays art and photographs like a museum on lab. The other lights up the room and even beams in the dark, faintly enough that at night you could see the stars. If these walls could talk, they'd tell me that it's gonna be okay. Each of them saying something new, something enchanting and overpowering. I stood up, opened the door, and I left. I sat outside in the sun. How's the world? They asked. I stared into the clouds, quiet, I said, as I faded adrift to just the voices in my head. This is a piece I did not publish, but I was told by Hillary that I really should share. It's called I Leave Here With. I leave here with the movement of my fingertips, moving across keys in a fast pace to get my thoughts in my head to transfer to to get every raw and honest emotion shown on a blank page. I leave here with the flutter of a faster heartbeat, creating an orchestra of spastic drum lines and violin ticks. The music plays so loud, I have to write down the lyrics, or my hands will shake into oblivion. I leave here with the better knowledge, yes, the cliche clip, the kiss of a better knowing of myself, along with people I call my friends who sit around me. I leave here with honesty, being true that things have happened, and they will stay that way. Drama became a chemical in the air that we breathe in most of these classes. But we learn how to put it on the page, turn the drama into a serenade to someone else out there in the world. I leave here with stories, that of my own and every living being around me. Whether you're a CD instead of a record, a Polaroid picture, the lock on the odd door, the superpower, the superstition, the love of a cheeseburger, Y equals MX plus B, the glow of moonlight, a soul on fire, or the very fact of just being human. I leave here with a reason to let my heart beat, a reason to let the ink move off my fingertips, to ask the question, how is the world? A reason to breathe, a reason to let my words see the light of day, knowing that everything at some point is gonna be okay. So I say thank you, all of you, for telling me and everyone else your stories, no matter who or what you are. Thank you.
Reading table of 12, page 102. At this table, many were lost, lost to the grave when the earth was hot. By swords they were slain and axes and spears. They died with their honor and they died with their fears. Kings fell with peasants and peasants with thieves. A war most brutal all could perceive. Their bodies left to fend for themselves, till God shall come from the skies and melt. Their long buried graves have fallen dead in small dark caves. And now we are here at the table for 12, the story just waiting to be unshelved. For when one is to read of the stories of tragedy, Sir Arthur Pendragon will rise along with some magic.
For me, I'll be reading my history on page 121. My history. Long nights, ghost stories, sleepy eyes, dream open in the dark, that's where I come from. Bright screens, thick books, loud music, dull pencils, that's where I come from. Crumpled paper, spilled paint, old brushes, cluttered drawers, that's where I come from. I am a nighttime writer, daytime dreamer, who hopes to brighten someone's day, hoping it may brighten mine. I come from wishful thinking and bad ideas that were never acted on. That's right.
Hi, I'm Ian Ellich, and I'll be reading Tandem on page 112. Tandem, empty souls filling their inner voids with camper holes, mouths hungry for social acceptance, diving into the latest health Googles, trying to win validation in the hopes of eliminating ever-present teenage goals, the chance to win a genuine friend, and now it's believing in the media trend. Mindsets very often set on calling blue in the local, as foggy as a long used by purple. Their phone data, their desire to put in reflection, just a finger tap away apps to make a connection. What they don't realize is it is often to the real thing a mere illusion, easily accessible celebrity gossip filling their developing brains with delusion. There are so many fun times, hidden lessons from them once realized, going off in their minds like tingly chimes. Life is hard for anyone, the essence of completely come down, but it is purely your choice whether or not it's one of the important things you want to crown. Hoping to find the one, often not realizing the importance of first the work on yourself being done, for it creates a more natural attraction of the good, it being so much sweeter than what forcing a bond could. Staying up late on academic deadlines, trying to skate, constantly searching for what makes you most whole, for many choices in how to present yourself, often to the real you, playing your role.
Hello, my name is Morgan, and I'll be reading The Doors in Life on page 139. Is this the door you've been looking for, the one that got away? Is this the right door? Should you walk through it or just pass it by? Is it the door to your victory or the door to your failure? Will you be in the same place if you walk through the store, or will you be brought to a new level in life, a better place or a worse place? Can you see the lies of this door, or is its pretty paint too distracting? Can you handle the heat of the metal knob on your cold flesh, that feeling of uncertainty, the need to see where it goes, with the desire to see, to sit back and watch someone else walk through it? Will you take the risk to walk up to it to see if you keep it?
Sandra Jones, and I'll be reading The Game of Life on 142. Once upon a time, boom, crash, gone. Why? Come back. You were like an ant to me. Why are the ants to take you away? You were loved by so many. Loving, kind, caring, fun. You're one of a kind of person. You could take a moment and make it last forever. Sorry I didn't come this summer. Wishing I could talk to you just one more time. Hot pink, Chloe. Sacramento River, Roma Red 2, Return of the Sea. You were an amazing, beautiful person. You were the life of the party. I missed in bed. I miss being in bed with you and snuggling and watching TV. You were always there for me when I needed you. I'll miss you forever, Heather. See you soon. I'm going to read a few, but they're short, so that's okay. First one is called Black and White, and it's a found poem inspired by this book called Heartless by Marissa Meyer. A black and white secret between the two of them, vanishing behind their coal-lined eyes. The standard of romance, isn't that a question? The answer is simple, as he grinned and she grinned back. The second one is Our Summer Days. Red and white plane flew by, don't know why, but it reminded me of our summer days. They were always so much more carefree. I think salt water does that to us. But in my conversations with nostalgia, you were the topic that we somehow always come back to. Wildflowers and cannonballs in the pool, tan skin and bare feet, running, run, 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 running through to the summer days, thinking it was endless, stopped short come autumn, and the cold winter froze me before the spring renewed me, but I'm just waiting for those carefree summer days. Oh, I didn't tell you the page numbers. Sorry. Anyway, this one's called Roses. It's actually it's irrelevant. Well, not really. It's for my brother, and he just got engaged. Okay. Lanterns above, reflected in your eyes. It's cold tonight. How many years have gone by? It seems it was always you, and roses have grown where I didn't believe they could anymore. My last one, it's called Haunted, and it's inspired by my best friend's dream that she had. You told me about getting lost in the woods. Wouldn't mind getting lost with you. Let's play hide and seek. We're all just kids getting lost in the woods. Hurry, run for cover. Don't get caught. It isn't safe. It's fine. No, it's not a game anymore. And there's more on the line. What have we done? At least I'm lost with you.
Okay, my name is Nicholas Lamb, and I'll be reading The King of Sacramento on page 160. When I enter this door, my career will be decided in 48 minutes. I enter the battle room with our uniforms laid out in front of us. We put them on so many times, but this time is special. Soon we will face our strongest enemy. There is one I must face. He is the key to make it to the league. My brothers around me are nervous to fight their enemies. When I go out to battle, I will defeat my matchup. I must use the oldest of the Ball brothers. Easy. It's just like back in Texas. No shooting required. Rely on my speed. My ability to make chaos in the defense. Play defense like you can pull up with a jumper that has more twist than a bullet push. My brothers are relying on me. I must use the hole in the armor of UCLA. I will win this game. With the Black Mamba at my feet and the mentality of zero, I will succeed. It's sad I must expose, though. However, I've heard he's better than Stephen Curry, so I must bring my A game. Mike, Bryant, and Allen are watching me now. It is my time to rise. As the soon-to-be-elected King of Sacramento, I will dominate my matchup and become the most important tool in this battle. I'm De'Aaron Fox, and I will create my story here and now, if God is my witness.
I'm here, John's battle. Read Life and Death on page 170. Life is something we see as light, good, and holy, but death we see as dark, bad, and sinful. Why do we see it that way? I say turn it around. Mankind is a monster that we cannot change because of the abuse and violence. People say death is sad. I say they are wrong. Death lets you go to a new life that is truly is pure. Light is filled with things we hate that cannot save. Look at it as a new point of view before it's too late, because I see the other side and it's peaceful.
Hi, I'm Cho Johnson. My friends call me TJ, and I will be reading two. First one is Love on page 181. If you were to cry, my shoulders will you make your eyes dry. If you were lost in the night, my heart will always be your light. If you were locked in a dungeon, my love for you will always bring it open. So when I see a beautiful face here and there, just know what I would do, that I would do anything, even die for you. My next one is Life Changer on page 182. I've always heard people talk about their heroes. For me, I never had one. Sometimes I felt like I was never going to find my hero. I looked at different ideas, doctors, movies, even superheroes. Nothing felt right. My heart was falling apart little by little each day. Until finally, one day I saw a special creature that I didn't think anyone else could see. It had a lizard-like body, huge bat wings, and razor-like claws. It was a dragon. Seeing it made me feel scared because it could kill these people. This dragon was glowing red and grew up to me. I didn't know what to do. I reached out and touched it. When I touched it, I felt stronger. During all my hard times, I find answers in the dragon. It makes me strong, who I am, and who I ever was. I will learn everything I can about dragons. The way the dragon taught me, even though I am afraid, fear cannot control me. I am the Dragon Master TJ.
Hi, I'm Lana, and I'll be reading Sunset on page 175. Pink, red, orange, yellow, so many beautiful colors. Clouds in the sky just above the water lies the sunset. The sunset represents many things, end of the day, time to sleep, darkness, and beauty, especially beauty. All the colors in the sky, all the shapes of the clouds, all the people looking out their window, all the people coming outside to witness a prize to their eyes, the sunset.
Come on now, you can do this. No one is going to outwork you tonight, then. Don't listen to your teammates if they're trying to tell you what position you're supposed to be at on the court. Remember, Ben, stay focused on every play, every quarter, and every minute you step your foot onto that court. Make sure you hustle, play good defense, and listen to the coach, and don't get mad if you miss a shot. Just remember what your dad told you. If you play defense, you won't come out of the game. Be like your ropes looking to attack the basket by any means necessary. Make sure you shoot the ball with confidence and be strong with the basketball. Ben, don't be distracted by the fans and the stands. Eat, sleep, and play basketball. This is what you do. The last game, you lost a bit of your momentum and your confidence, but now you're going to ball out. Step on the court like you're the best. Now come on, Ben. Let's go get that W.
Yes. A little louder than that, thank you, Matt.
Yes!
So I hope that you walk out the door tonight feeling really proud, and I know we'll all, you know, have this on our bookshelf and our nightstands for a long time to come and enjoy your words years from now. So really, really good job. Before you all scatter, ask the authors to come up for a group picture. So bring your book. We're going to hold our books and take it. Hang on, don't move yet. The rest of you, please enjoy all of your herbs and dust it so we don't have to take them home. Thank you so much for giving audience to our amazing writers tonight. We really appreciate you being here. So let's take a picture.